Hello friends, in this video we are going to solve example 4.2 that is taken from chapter number 4, axial load, and book name is Mechanics of Material by RC Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement is, the rigid beam AB rests on two short posts as shown in figure. AC is made of steel and has diameter of 20 mm and BD is made of aluminum and has diameter of 40 mm. Determine the displacement of point F on AB if vertical load of 90 kN is applied over this post. Take E, modulus of elasticity of steel is 200 GPa and for aluminum 70 GPa. So you can see this is the rigid beam that is supported on post AC and BD. This is made up of, this post AC is made up of steel while this post BC is made up of aluminum. Clear? And the diameter of each post is given and a point load of 90 kN is applied at point F. So you have to determine the vertical displacement of this point F due to this 90 kN load. So let's start with the solution. So first step is that you can see that 90 kN load is applied on it, and if you remove this vertical post from this rigid beam, so they will offer a vertical reaction force. Let this will be RBD and this will be RAC. So we'll find this RBD and RAC first. So I will draw the free bar diagram of this beam. This is the beam. The load or the reaction force offered by this short post AC will be equal to RAC, and the vertical reaction offered by this short post BD will be equal to RBD. And there is point F and we have applied a 90 kN load on this point. So this is 90 kN. Okay, the distance from this end F till point B, this is point B, this distance is given as 400 millimeter, and distance from this point A till point F, this is 200 millimeter. So total length is 600 millimeter. So we'll find this RA and RAC and RBD by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all moments about point A is equal to zero, taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point A, the first moment is due to 90 kN load and perpendicular distance is 200 millimeter, and this is producing clockwise moment, so it will be negative. So I will write it minus 90 into 200. Now the second load is due to this RBD and this is producing counterclockwise moment about this point A, and perpendicular distance is 600, and this is counterclockwise, so it will be positive. So I can write plus RBD into 600 is equal to zero. So from here we will get this 600 RBD is equal to 90 multiplied by 200. So RBD will be equal to 90 multiplied by 200 divided by 600. So from here we will get 90 divided by 3, and that will be equal to 30 kN. So what we get is RBD is 30 kN. Now we'll find this RAC by using another equation of equilibrium, and that equation is sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero and upward force is taken as positive. So you can see RAC plus RBD minus 90 will be equal to zero. I can write RAC plus RBD is 30 kN minus 90 is equal to zero. So from here you will get this RAC will be equal to 60 kN. Now these are the reaction forces offered by this short columns on this rigid beam. Clear? As a result, this beam will apply same force in opposite direction. So it means that this column AC and BC, they are in compression. So I will draw the free body diagram of this both short beam or column, sorry. So this is, let This is column AC that is made up of steel. So from here you can see this will be RAC, that is 60 kilonewton, and from the base it will be also exerting a vertical reaction force, means this will be in compression. I will write short post AC, which is made up of steel. Similarly, for short post or short post BD, this will be also in compression, and the vertical load here will be equal to RBD, and this RBD will be equal to 30 kilonewton. Now, what does it mean that due to this compressive load, we will get the displacement of this end A and B, which will be downward because these are fixed. They are on the floor. So this point A and point B that is on this short column will move downward. So we'll find this in compression or shortening in length of this AC and BC. So I will write for post BC first. This let me clear the screen. So for short, let's start with the first one, that is short post AC. So for post AC, I can write displacement of point A with respect to C, or it can also be written as delta A is equal to PAC or RAC into length of AC divided by area of AC into E of steel, because this is made up of steel. So just plug in the value, RAC is 60 kilonewton. So 60 into 10 to the power minus 3. And you can see this load is compressive. So I will write negative sign with that. Multiply by length. So length of each post is 300 millimeter. So in meter it is 0.300 meter. Divide by area of AC. So diameter of AC is 20 millimeter. So its radius is 10 millimeter. Or you can also write area with diameter, area of circular section with diameter D is pi by 4 D square. So I can write 0.02 square into E. E of steel is given as 200 gigapascal. So 200 into 10 to the power 9 pascal. So when you solve, you will get displacement of point A comes out to be minus 286 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter. Or you can say displacement of point A is 0.286 millimeter, and it is downward. So point A moves downward. Now what we will do is that for post BD, that is made up of aluminum, this point B will move downward, and that will be equal to RBD into length of BD divided by area of BD into E. So E of aluminum. So RBD is 30 kilonewtons, so 30 into 10 to the power 3, multiply by both short posts are same length, so 300 millimeter, which is 0.300 meter, divide by area. So diameter of this aluminum is post is 40 millimeter, so its area will be equal to pi by 4, diameter in meter is 0.04 whole square, multiply by E of aluminum, which is 70 gigapascal. So 70 into 10 to the power 9. So when you solve this, you will get displacement of point B will be 102 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter. And you can see that post BC is also in compression. So there will be a negative sign with that. So if I put negative sign, so this will be also negative. So it means that point B is also moving downward with 0.102 millimeter. Okay. Now what if I draw a original line of AB? So if I draw it like A, this is point A, this is point B, and this is point F. Clear? And distance from A to F was 200 millimeter. And distance from F to B was 400 millimeter. Now, when you apply a load of 90 kilonewton on that, so we have seen that this post will shorten in length and this point A will move downward. Similarly, point B will move downward. So point A moves 0.286 millimeter downward, while point B moves 0.102 millimeter downward. So if I move this point A to a new point, for example, this is your newer point A dash. So we have seen that this distance will be represented as del A. And this del A is how much? 0.286 millimeter. And point B is also moving to a new point. Let this point is point B dash. And you can see that this displacement is delta B, which is equal to 0.102 millimeter. And this point F will move to this new point. Sorry. This point F will move toward this point. Clear? This point will move called new point F dash. So F dash is change in position of point F. So how will find this delta F dash? I can write this displacement is delta F. So what if I can take, if I take a horizontal line from this? So you can see if this point is point, for example, O. So we can see that del F is equal to FO plus OF dash. So what is OF? Yeah, RFO. So OF, RFO, you can see this is again same to BB dash. And that is 0.102 millimeter. So I can write 0.102 millimeter. Now what about this OF dash? So OF dash can be obtained by using similar triangle. So you can see we have one triangle is this one, larger one, and the second one is this smaller one. So if I take the ratio of their side, it will be same. So what I do is that if I take if I take this triangle and this triangle, these are both similar triangle. So the ratio of their side will be same. So this side divide by this, I will write it. So this side is again equal to 0.286 minus this distance, which is 0.102. And that will give you 0.184. So let me write it here. This distance is 0.184 millimeter. So if I take this 0.184 divided by total length, which is 600, will be equal to this OF dash divided by 400. I will repeat it. If I take this distance divided by this 600 millimeter, that will be same this OF dash divided by 400 millimeter. So from that, I can write this OF dash will be equal to 0.184 multiply by 400 divided by 600. So now just plug these two values in this formula. So you will get del F will be equal to 0.102 plus 0.184 multiply by 400 millimeter divided by 600 millimeter. And when you solve this, you will get displacement of point F comes out to be 0.225 millimeter. And that will be downward because both point A and P moving downward, causing this F will also move downward. So this is the answer of our this question. And that was all about this example 4.2. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.